تبارك الذي نزل الفرقان على عبده ليكون للعالمين نذيرا.
بسم الله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. In the battle of Uhud, when the mushrikeen were scattering and fleeing and the Muslims were giving chase and they could taste victory, some of the Sahaba that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam placed on the mountain in defensive positions left their places because they thought the Muslims had won. This allowed Khalid ibn Walid radiyallahu anhu, who at the time hadn't embraced Islam yet, to circle around the back and then attack the Muslims from the rear. In the confusion and the panic that ensued, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, along with a few of his companions, were left isolated and they came under severe attack from the mushrikeen. The mushrikeen now wanted to snatch victory from the jaws of defeat and they wanted to fulfill their ultimate goal, which was to kill the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The few Sahaba that were around the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam were fighting fiercely and they were literally putting their lives on the line, and many of them became martyred in this way. But because of the intensity of the attack from the kuffar, the blessed face of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was wounded and he also sustained other injuries. Among the Sahaba who were defending the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was Mus'ab ibn Umair, and he was fighting courageously and he was fighting and fighting and fighting until he himself was martyred. And because he resembled the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam so much, the mushrikeen thought they had achieved their goal. They thought they had fulfilled their mission, which was to kill the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So they shouted and proclaimed, "Muhammad has been killed." Now I want you to imagine this. You've just received news that the person you love the most on the face of the earth has either passed away or been killed. Understandably, the morale of the Sahaba was deflated and anxiety spread amongst them. And this ultimately led to defeat and a lot of sadness amongst the Sahaba. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala decided to reveal some verses regarding this incident. And he said, وَمَا مُحَمَّدٌ إِلَّا رَسُولٌ. And Muhammad is but a messenger. قَدْ خَلَتْ مِنْ قَبْلِهِ الرَّسُولُ. Other messengers have passed on before him. أَفَإِنْ مَاتَ. So now, if he dies, just like Musa and Harun and many other prophets and messengers died before him, أو قُتِل, like Yahya عليه السلام, or many prophets that were sent to Bani Israel were killed, إِنْ قَلَبْتُمْ عَلَىٰ عَقَابِكُمْ. Will you turn back on your heels? Will you go back to how you were before Islam? وَمَنْ يَنْقَلِبْ عَلَىٰ عَقِبَيْهِ فَلَنْ يَضُرَّ اللَّهَ شَيْئًا. And whoever turns back on his heels, then this person will not harm Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the slightest. وَسَيَجْزِ اللَّهُ الشَّاكِرِينَ. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will reward the grateful. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives us an example of the people that came before us, and he says, وَكَأَيِّن مِّن نَبِيٍ قَاتَلَ مَعَهُ رِبِّيُّونَ كَثِيرٌ. And how many a prophet fought, and alongside him and with him fought his devout companions who loved him dearly. فَمَا وَهَنُوا لِمَا أَصَابَهُمْ فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ. And they didn't lose their spirit due to the afflictions that they faced in the path of Allah. وَمَا ضَعُفُوا وَمَا اسْتَكَانُوا. They didn't weaken, nor did they submit. وَاللَّهُ يُحِبُّ الصَّابِرِينَ. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala praises them here, and he says, he loves those who are steadfast, those who are patient. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is teaching the Sahaba a lesson here, and he's given them an example of how the previous nations were. In the face of calamity, they didn't lose their spirit. They didn't weaken and nor did they submit. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling them to be like these people. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives this example to teach the Sahaba and us how to react in our times of calamity. And he also teaches us a dua here. And he shows us how these people reacted. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَمَا كَانَ قَوْلَهُمْ إِلَّا أَنْ قَالُوا. And the only thing that they said is, رَبَّنَ اغْفِرْ لَنَا ذُنُوبَنَا. Our Lord, forgive us our sins. This is how the believers react in this situation. They didn't say why and they didn't complain. The thing that they turned back to and the person that they blame is themselves. So they ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for forgiveness. And they say, رَبَّنَ اغْفِرْ لَنَا ذُنُوبَنَا وَإِسْرَافَنَا فِي أَمْرِنَا. Oh Allah, our Lord, forgive us our sins and our transgressions against others. And the scholars have mentioned there is a wisdom here to be taken. They're asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive them their sins because the sins are something which necessitates defeat and would prevent them from victory. So they're asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive them so they can attain that victory. And then they go on to say in the dua, وَثَبِّتْ أَقْدَامَنَا. And plant firmly our feet. They're asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give them strength. They're asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to also give them patience and steadfastness, all qualities which are needed for victory. And then they say, وَانْصُرْنَا عَلَى الْقَوْمِ الْكَافِرِينَ. And aid us against the disbelieving people. And here, it's as if they're saying, oh Allah, we are believers, we believe in you and we believe in the messengers that you have sent. We are fighting against your enemy, oh Allah, so aid us against them. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala then replies to them and he says, فَآتَاهُمُ اللَّهُ ثَوَابَ الدُّنْيَا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave them the good of this world. وَحُسْنَ ثَوَابِ الْآخِرَةِ. And the excellent reward of the hereafter. وَاللَّهُ يُحِبُّ الْمُحْسِنِينَ. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves the doers of good. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala teaches us this dua. this dua that we can use in our times of calamity. And the lesson that we learn here is that the sabirin, the people that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala praises, the believers, the thing that they turn to in the time of calamity is the repentance and the forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah mentions in a couple of other places in the Quran, and he says, وَمَا أَصَابَكُم مِّن مُصِيبَةٍ فَبِمَا كَسَبَتْ أَيْدِيكُمْ. And whatever harm afflicts you, then this is what your own hands have earned. And in another ayah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, ظَهَرَ الْفَسَادُ فِي الْبَرِّ وَالْبَحْرِ بِمَا كَسَبَتْ أَيْدِي النَّاسِ. Corruption has appeared on the land and the sea because of what? Because of what the hands of men have earned. So in the face of calamity, my dear brothers and sisters, the first thing that we should turn to is to repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to seek His forgiveness. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to keep us firm and steadfast in the face of these calamities. You see many scenarios in which people might lose their faith or leave the deen. So we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to keep us firm and to help us against the disbelievers and the enemy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to aid us. And with His help, nothing is unachievable. We'll end it there for this episode. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Jazakumullahu khairan, brothers and sisters, for watching. May Allah bless you all. Please leave a like, comment down below, and subscribe, and share this video so that we can all be part of the Quranic revival. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.